this man is going to walk us through the forms that we have in front of us. He is an important character, Jay.
Yeah, so our very first speaker for the 2013 NBC is here for a very specific reason. He has played a tremendous role in the promoting quality in various coffee organizations. He has served as the co-founder of the Cup of Excellence. He is a Cup of Excellence head judge. He has 35 years experience analyzing, grading, cupping, processing, and trading coffee. He is a cupper and professor certified with recognition by the Brazilian government, and a member of the BSCA, the Brazilian Specialty Coffee Association. He is also co-author with Mr. George Howell of the Cup of Excellence Cupping Protocols. That's pretty impressive.
Yeah. So, welcome, Silvio.
Thank you.
Now, Silvio, would you like a mic like this or one of... Okay, great, great. Okay, so this is how it's going to work. Silvio is going to walk us through this. We're then going to go cup coffees. When you have questions, I've got a mic. Feel free to raise your hand. I'll come and run. Let's make sure that we really get it at the end of this. Does that sound good, Silvio?
Sounds good.
Okay, great.
Great. Thank you very much. Good morning, everyone. It's a big honor for me to come in to talk about Cup of Excellence, to be in this event. And thanks for having me here for all the organization. So I go a little bit quickly, because I have slides that I think that can speak better than myself in much different ways. So let's go. In Brazil, you have all these different altitude where you produce coffee, many different regions, from 700 to 1,400 meters, many different characters and many different attributes for each coffee. So since you start the farm, the location is very important, but then the risk before we get a nice cup of coffee that like we have downstairs, the risk of it to make a mistake is so huge, like implantation, harvest, transportation, process, drying system, that is a key point for the coffee, how you hold it. Anything that you make a mistake, you follow down, you lost your quality. Warehouse, transportations overseas until the coffee arriving here. Roast, that now we are learning much more how to roast, how is the perfect profile for each roast. So packing, preparation, and of course, the baristas, how you serve your coffee. Any mistake, I mean, you make problem for your final cup. So to have an excellent cup of coffee is a long way to have this. So, telling this, let's show some Brazilian farms how it looks like the topography, the geography. Looks, the Brazilian farms, we don't have too much shade coffee, like topography like this. In some places, yes, some not. This is Bahia. This also have a plateau like savannas, where you have like 700 to 1,000 meters that there was mechanized plantations in these farms like this. Then you have irrigation like this, or like this one here. And then the flowering start. Probably you know that since the coffee start you plant is about 3 years for to have the first collection. But then every year, in case of Brazil, have one crop. And the main flowering time is October until December. And the harvesting period depends on the region, like Cerrados is April until August in the mountains. Is the period of harvesting. Time of harvesting. The best way should be this one here, but of course, always you have some immature, that means you became commercial or high commercial, however, then something really good and some naturals, even naturals on the trees. I guess many of you have been in the farm before. Have you seen this before? That's right. How many of you have been in the farms before? Have you seen all these? Good, great. And how much of you have been using this cupping form before? You'll be helping me a lot here today. I can go and spend more time cupping. So, but this is what Brazil, before all this program we do not produce, is that quality there. You know why? Because I don't have a way and where we have to sell this coffee. So it was not sustainable. So in 1999, when we start Cup of Excellence, our gourmet project, even we do not have this farm because I do not have yet tools how we can manage the scoring. So we start some competition even before to have something really, how we can have an equal system to analyze all this coffee. This is why this was created. It was a consequence of our wish how to put the best coffee that produced in Brazil in front of the buyers. And in fact, this means we change completely the way how to select the coffee. The producers start to have much more recognition. Us, as a cupper, we understand better and have some tools how to analyze. However, if it's Cup of Excellence, Cupping Forum, or SCCAA, or any other, but to have much more tools to analyze. And then you, as a buyer and cuppers, you have a way where you can find and take the coffee from the best place where it can grow, in Brazil or any other country. Look, this is the hand picking that we do not have before there. This is also another reality in Brazil because the labor cost is improving too much. It's mechanical harvest. Then you have to some selecting machine to select the cherries after this machine. It's a long way. So finishing harvesting, you have different ways how to process coffee in Brazil. The main is 90% of Brazilian coffee is natural. Natural means that you use only the cherries and you dry. In different systems, but you dry only cherries. And then this other process is washing, passed to this mucilator, the preparation. And after that, you take the parchments and you dry. What you call pulp the natural, dismucilated, or fully washed. Fully washed is when you use a fermentation tank. So this is how the entire process. You have all the chances in Brazil when you have a farm, how you can process. So this is some pictures how you can dry more volume of naturals. And this is much more for specialties like dry beds, this African beds, or this greenhouse style. This is also pretty new. This is the last 20 years in Brazil that you are improving and processing these micro lots. This was what they call this coffee revolution quality in Brazil to discover all this process. You cannot find this before this time. So the coffee cherries that you may know, and they have inside this parchment that we take it out. When it's natural, we dry all this together. When we process, we take out this first skin, and then I have the mucilage around this, and this is inside of the bean when you cut. So let's go quickly to the proposal of a Cup of Excellence. Always to build some relation between the country, can be Brazil, and after Brazil was the first one was Guatemala, and then was Colombia, and all other countries that I have a chance to work in all of them. And every country you can show the best that this country can produce. This is the relation between the country, the coffee that is produced, and you. You can have connect with this quality. In the case of Brazil, is a new thing is happening. Is the natural flavor that the people are discovering. The natural coffee before was always like what you can say 75 point, always some astringent, some immature flavor. And right now they are processing much more careful, only cherries. This make a huge difference, but it's still long way how we have to process naturals, because I have to be safe if it's fruit or fermented or a wine taste or however. But this is, if we can compare like the marked wine, we are just start walking. I have a lot to learn as a producer, as a buyer. So naturals has a huge way and long way to go. So for the pulp the natural, for washed, it's much more comfortable because you, when you're processing this style, you bring this under your control. But the mainly Cup of Excellence was to build a relationship between producing and consuming countries. The foundation of a Cup of Excellence, always to be Cup of Excellence coffee that will be start has to be clean and sweet. This is two keywords. Without these two keywords, cannot start to be specialties. And then the flavor after taste, how is the equilibrium between all the attributes, and then of course your preference in evaluation. The calibration, because here is the country is the focus is Brazil. We are getting together familiarity with the attributes that are from Brazil, with the protocols that mainly you know, the protocols, and to introduce this format. As soon as we finish here, I have 7 coffees to cup. In your book, it shows 6 lots, but I introduce one more for you because I think that should be more interesting for have more discussion in quality. You know, when you cup, always you change. I mean, your body change. When you cup in the morning is one way, in the afternoon is the other way. So it's more really important for you to understand yourself when you cup. And of course, when you start cupping, avoid to go always in the same way. So 1-7 or 7-1. When you have something different, try to approach samples in different ways. It's much easier for professional cuppers. And don't forget it. Coffees always talk to you. The message is in the beans. So special for us in the production countries, when they show something wrong, fermented, immature, dirty, when I get, I know where I have to go to correct. But something is, you have the maximum potential quality, this is maximum. But the coffee always talk to you. And please avoid to cup too many times, some coffee that you it bothers you, is not like so much, that make influence in your total scores. Aromas is not, evaluated here as scores, but it's really important because we start in drink and enjoy some coffee, always from aroma. And everything is here, is our mind. So always our palates, everything that I have, a record you have in mind. So what you like or dislike. So from the nose, when you get the aromas, and then when you taste. Both go the same way, but sometimes part of these aromas or taste, you can feel it in dry, but you cannot feel when you cup. So this is very important for you to follow all steps to have the correct evaluation for the coffee beans. Sorry to be a little bit quickly in this one, but as the organization said, I have to be on time.
Keep going.
Thank you. So everyone has 1 cup each to evaluate the dry, the grounds. So you just evaluate yours. So then you take your cup, you're gently, you can shake and smell. Please avoid to make it very strong. This, is important. You don't need this. Just can do it gently and put it back. And you just touch your cup. It has 1 for each cupper. And then when you break the cups, you can stir, you move 3 times the coffees. Why 3 times? Because if I do 2 or 4, you can change a little bit the quality. The instructions will be different. And sorry, I have a lot of influence of Portuguese. My English sometimes mixes some words. So this you finish to break, clean, and then you're ready to cup to start. How the attributes appear in the form. You have 8 columns of positive points. Clean cup, that is one of the key word, that's clean, no off flavor, clarity. Sweet, that is the results of when you harvesting correct point, if not it became astringent or immature. How is the individual flavors works together, like acidity is really important. And even in the beginning, when we started this cupping form, we don't know how to score acidity to be in fact, because I don't know what could be quality, what could be negative points, until we discover what it means intensity and the quality of the acidity. So, but it's the basics. And the mouthfeel, please, the mouthfeel is not related to flavor. Mouthfeel is always what you feel in your mouth. Only this. Flavor is another thing. How these combinate attributes work together. Combination aroma, that is not part of evaluation, and the taste. And what makes some coffee is really very unique. Some floral notes, some chocolate, these are flavors. And how these equilibrium work together. Some coffee has a very clean, very sweet, but it's not the lingering, it's not the aftertaste, not so long. So it's not well balanced. So you have to make all these attributes clear in all the coffees to make, the perfect score, the perfect coffee. overall, this item, we are thinking even to change for complexity, because he's a little bit personal, if you like or not, but in the professional way. You just cannot say, I do not like. What is the reason that you do not like? So has some specific reason, or just do not like because, I mean, do not impress. If you do not impress, tell why. It's missing body, it's missing sweet, that you can affect your entire cupping attributes. And of course, this is your preference in the table. So you have some, in this attribute, in this column, you can show your preference. So in this score, if you take like four points, is below commercial. If you do something like five, if you give all five scores in this all this cupping form, this means a 76 point. This is a standard commercial. Can be commercial, even a little bit high commercial. This is the score that you have. Six, we start to talk. This became a specialty. But to be cup of excellence has to be six in all those, and one of these columns has to be seven, because I need to be 85 points, at least. Seven, exceptional, and eight is what really what they're looking for. The presidential word, optimal. So this again, like five and six, that is the sweetened and clean, and then when you have some more complex, seven and eight. This is how I can analyze some coffee pyramid before, and before most of the quality was until here, in the case of Brazil. And then after all this program, we start to having all this. This is what I have, COE coffees, BSCA, certified coffees that is going into this category of specialties. So using this scale, so five, without nothing special, just the average, that's good. Six, you have something really nice to go. And please, always when analyze, try to approach some at least three times, in hot, medium, and a little bit cold, or getting cooler. This is easier for you because you can have a different sensation, and then you can make much more sure about your evaluation. Sometimes it's going up, sometimes it's going down. And why the coffee or the lot is doing this way. So how to use in this? Suppose it is in this category, like aftertaste, you give first six, your first impression. That is nice, it's beautiful. But then you wait a little bit, you refresh a little bit, you come back again to the cup. When you come back again to the cup, you think, was not there. I have to reduce because it's not finished longer. It's not pleasant anymore. So this is why you send the mark. And then in the final end, you have to put your mark. What is your final score for each attribute? Because then when the auditors or who be analyzing your cupping scores, they can see clear what is your score. Always you have to mention your number in the end, like this four. This one, the key point. Please, always in acidity and mouthfeel, analyze quality, not intensity. Intensity of acidity can be very sharply, something in negative way, but the quality is the key point in any coffee. That is really important. This is why I had a big trouble when we start. How to analyze well the acidity. As well, for the mouthfeel. Mouthfeel sometimes is a big body, but is the astringent way. Is immature. So this is important for you to understand. Again, our cupping today, usually in cup of excellence, I use some material that is sometimes coffee higher and much lower than these lots today. Today we start a little bit around 8 points. But in cup of excellence, normal calibration, I use like 75 and up. And today, of course, is different meanings for our work today. The facts, how it works, is just one column. Suppose that out of four cups that you have on the table, you have two cups that is fermented. But one of those cups is slightly fermented and another cup is really very strong fermented. Is one thing is you call for your head judge because this coffee may be disqualified. But suppose the coffee is not strong enough to be disqualified. And having two cups, one is light and one is strong defect as fermented, all you analyze as the strongest one. And you put two cups in the strongest one. Like you can have two cups here. The intensity, you can vary it slightly as one, medium two, and very strong as three. So in this case, as the two cups, one dose is very strong, you have three as intensity, time is four, that is number of cups that you have on the table. So that means 24 negative points in this coffee, because you are not looking for a specialty for coffee that is fermented. So this is why it's a pretty aggressive, it's pretty hard, but this is how we develop the cupping form. Adding points in the end, so you please, you can sum clean, sweet, acidic, all these together. Then you take it out your defects, if you have some, plus 36. Where coming from this 36? This is a coefficient number that show all the time. Because, I mean, all our column is not 10, it's 8. So then always have this adjusted number of 36 point. Before I try, and you did thousands of exercise, without these coefficient numbers, using a column of 10, but does not work so well. So this is why we start to calibrate and work with people using this system. Okay, can go ahead. What this course means? Below 8, not specialty. That's good, commercial, high commercial, but not specialty. 80 to 84, yes, specialty, but not exemplary. It's good, it's nice, nice a lot, but it's not cup of excellence yet. 85 to 90, yes, this is cup of excellence selection. And of course, after that is presidential selection. General tests, that how you make. Here, Jay, are you have some place where you'll be holding the roasting for the people to see? The roasting color?
That's a good question. I can check with them.
Okay.
I will check.
If you have, normally when we start cupping, you can check the roasting column. I mean, the first one, you can see if the color is, according to the standard that will be in the top, or if it's a little bit lighter or darker. So far as I checked yesterday, it seems that it's really good roast. Then everyone can evaluate, dry, and break just one cup, but then we cup all four cups. That's clear? And please, the tables leaders always will be a calling for the water. We saw already all the our table leaders. And then we can start putting water together from both sides to be exactly the same way and the same temperature. Then you smell the crust. You can analyze. You take your notes. And then wait 4 minutes after the middle point. So we have 7 coffees, can be indeed 3.5. Then we start your chronometer. Then when it's 4 minutes left, you can start and break your cup. It's clear? When it's so silent like this, or everyone understand or no one understand.
Yeah, that's the real question. Does anybody actually have a question at this point? Because it really, the silence is scary, isn't it? Yeah. Any questions right now?
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
that's good.
Going. So, yeah, okay.
So table leaders, please assist in good preparation, just to make as much as possible to have the best cup that we can, to make sure that everything does in the correct way for us to have a nice way to cup. Please check the water if it's really hot, and to avoid to lose the quality of this coffee. Is a little bit late to say a basic rules, but do not use perfume. If not, you have to take a shower again. Please, this is extremely important. As David already said, is silence. This is your communications between you and coffee. Please, we are, 200 cuppers here. So when you be cupping, try, when you cup, is communication to you and the coffee. If someone that just come in, hey, Silvio. So this start, immediately it break the communication. So you have to start over again. So when you saw someone cupping, okay, let them finish. When you finish, you can ask, you can talk, no problem. But this is really important for you to take your decision and how is your feeling, what you think about that specific lot. Okay? I don't know if you have these rules here about the phones. If
we
the phone is ringing, yeah, you have these here.
No phone. I mean, of course, we know what you are like out here, audience. But please try not to be distracted. No conversations.
Yeah, because I mean, our rules normally when the telephone rings, this person has to pay around a beer for everyone in the room. So
200 beers in Norway is more
and
than
beer,
you make.
Beer in Norway is pretty expensive. And please, again, all four cups you have to taste. It's not just the one that you smell and break. And don't forget to at least to cup three times. And the middle of the cupping today, I will start talking to show who is the farm and what is the overall opinion about that quality. So I will not wait until the really very cold, until the coffee is getting really cold because of the time. Another way, please, we are in group. And when you cup, is even for the cup of excellence, some judges like to impress others. And sometimes they take a smell, this is not good. So all the judges that make like this, sometimes want to impress, but mainly are not very safe because sometimes they need some people agreement. So please, we are professional cuppers. We cup. We do not say, we can talk about other things, but not about coffee until the end. So we take our own opinion, but we do not try to like expression, like or dislike. Wait until the end. Maybe some of your colleagues like for some reason. Maybe you don't. So please, no forcing to make too much expressions. We are not doing here a competition for cuppers. Is a kind of working together to getting the best result that we can together. And just relax. Do not overthink about the results. Go and take your perception. The more relaxed you are able to cup, more easier for you to enjoy the cupping. And then the more difficult things for the cuppers is to communication. How you can write down about the attributes. Sometimes it's hard. Mainly, even cuppers, they ask for some specific test for how you can describe. I am very good in giving score, but I'm not giving descriptions. Like, this coffee is sweetness, but which kind of sweetness? Or floral? Or chocolate notes? All this is something is different way. But try as much as possible to put what is coming up first to your mind in different attributes. Please, guys, let's go there to cup and enjoy. And then I'll be come back here to talk when it'll be the coffee is getting cooler. Please.
All right, so remember, your cupping table is on your name tag. So look at your name tag. Cup table number 1 is here. Table number 14 and 15 are over here. So look at the number and walk to your table.
On the first position, sample number 1, was a natural coffee. Could you get that? That was natural preparation? No? So this is from this farm that is on the screen. The variety is Catuai. Natural process, 1,050 meters. So just to come back a little bit, if you have... Talk about the preference now. Oops. For this sample number 1, who has a score? Someone score over 90 for this one.
And he scores over 90 on this coffee.
Over 85, I should say.
And he scores over 85 on this coffee.
Between, is one, Simo. Between 80 to 84 and a half. Whoops.
14, 16, 18.
More or less the middle. And between 75 to 79. Okay. Who scores mostly was around this 80 to 84 points. So someone could tell me the attributes that has this coffee?
Mia.
Oh, it's a sweet coffee, quite mellow, lots of honey molasses, a little bit of florals, really nice finish with caramel, very sweet coffee.
Thank you, Mia. So for the natural, this coffee is very fresh, it's very recently harvested. So it's really difficult one because it's just coming up from the farm right now. It's not very the fruit side, but more a little bit of wine, nice flavor. So some other comments about the sample number one?
Anybody else?
Just for your reference, this sample was scored around the 80 to 82 for most of the cuppers in Brazil before this sample came here. Very round body and some fruit in the and lingering aftertaste. But this was the result for this coffee before. So going next, goes the next second sample. And please, for every sample when you pass through, if some, for some of you is your best sample on the table, you raise your hand. You tell me it, okay? Just for me to see what is the preference in these tables. Sample number two is this farm here called Caxambu Farm. Is a sul de Minas, is a Mundo Novo variety. Is 1,000 meters altitude. Is a pulped natural. This is the farm. Now come back to the results. For the sample number two, some of you score over 90 points. No? 85 to 89. One, two, three, between 80 to 84 and a half. Okay, who scores? Between 75 and 79. Two, three, is a few those. So who score higher? Could you give some comments in this coffee? Sure. Who can tell me about some coffee attributes?
Okay. Somebody, who's going to comment on this?
We have a room full of shy folks.
Oh, it's true.
So no comments? How's about which kind of body this? Because we changed for natural from pulp to natural. That's changed the preparation as well. So which kind of character, what is the body of this coffee? Do you have some relation? Which kind of body you have in this lot? Acidity. Okay, it remembers some citric notes or some tangerine or more tartaric like grapes. So this is important notes when you cup to follow through. So it's important because you are just making exercise. As you are doing some competition here downstairs, so it's nice for you to take some of these notes, make it easier for you to getting involved with the coffee and why you are scoring. Can you go next?
Yep, let's go next. And I'm not going to take no for an answer now. Somebody is going to start passing comment on these coffees.
So this one here is... Planalto Farm is Qualic FX, is also south of Minas, yellow Catuai, pulped natural. This is the lot. And the producers.
Okay.
Talk about evaluation. Do you have a score over 90 points? 85 to 89?
One, there are several.
Two. Several, 80 to 84. Okay. 75, 79. Also several. I have in many different places. Who likes this coffee? Why? Please.
Adi.
Okay, I like this coffee because it stood out a little bit. It was different from a lot of others. It had the really sweet tobacco that I thought was memorable. It had vanilla in it also. So this was one of my favorite.
Great. I mean, using this coffee, you should use it as a state. If you can use, you can use it as a state or a blend for espresso. Can you have some idea how you could use better in this kind of profile?
Are you asking me?
Yeah. It's a secret you cannot tell?
No. I kind of like it just as a drinking coffee because it had these attributes. It had that tobacco that is... And it was clean. So that's when you have a clean tobacco, I like that.
Great.
So I would just drink it in a brewed coffee, not blended.
State. So this is good, the exercise. I was talking that always when I have a chance, we select something for some reason. So according to our client's preference, it's like a food. We do not have all the same food every day. You have a choice. Then when I have a chance to select different things, we select for some reason. And again, the coffee has to, I mean, to convince you why. Exactly like we ask now. For some people, I may not use that coffee as a single state. For some, yes. The preference for usually for North European, mainly here, is much more acidic taste, like. Much more Italian taste is a little bit more dry finish. It's different. Who is right? No, it's preference. It's just for enjoy. Coffee is pleasure. It's just to have fun. No one is, you must have this coffee. No, you have to take coffee for pleasure. So this is what I learned. So we can have the best as we can. Let's go next. Some more comments in this one?
Let's go to the next. Keep going.
This is a good question. This is a new crop or past crop? Yeah, past crop. He's a little bit bag in the taste, that's right.
Silvio, what score did that come in on the Cup of Excellence?
Yeah, this for Brazil has been 80 to 81, but okay. What was impressed was this different character. Was the Brazilians Cooper selected this specific lot because of these flavor attributes. This is why this lot was coming here for this presentation. The number two. Let me take my glasses.
Number four.
82, 84, around this. Now, sample number four. This is the farm. Sul de Minas region. Variety is Mundo Novo. Also Pope the Natural, 1,000 meters altitude where it is grow. Okay, quality analysis, quality comments. Over 90. I have someone that like this one. But let me ask you first about the fragrance. But this coffee has something different also in the aromas. Someone likes a lot the fragrance aromas of this coffee? Could smell? Yes? Yeah?
Yeah, I really love this coffee. This coffee stands out for me. It's got a juicy, fantastic for tropical fruits, a melon, and it's very precise and complex.
This is your preference, is your highest score in this table, or you have something different?
Yes, it's the highest for me.
Only the highest. Okay. So over 90 score. You have some scores over 90? One. Good. Between 85 to 89? Good. 80 to 84? Great. So below 80? One, two. Yeah. So who scored over 90? Could you share the comments with us?
Aaron, was that you? Were you? Yeah.
Yeah, I thought it was incredibly unique. A lot of that tropical fruit came out as it cooled in the finish, and the aroma, the fragrance got me right away, too. It was really interesting.
Mm-hmm. So, for me, it was a really very floral note, in the beginning, and then also when you cup, you can feel something like that. So for us in Brazil, this coffee is 8.5 over. It can be 8.5 to 8.6. This is why this come here with this score. And all the attributes really works very well together. Very impressed. Some more comments, please.
Addy?
I just want to ask you, in your opinion, was this the coffee with the most acidity on the table?
In my opinion, has another one that has more interesting acidity. That was the last one because of the combination. So, but was really, nice one. Very, spicy, sophisticated. But the last coffee has a little bit more balanced acidity. Can you go next?
Yes, next one.
So this is Bella Vista Farm, also from the Minas Gerais, pulped natural, 1,000 meter. Please, some comments. Over 90 score, we have some. 85 to 89. One. 80 to 84. Few. 75-79. Few again. So
there don't seem to be many people actually raising their hands here.
Yeah.
I mean, it's
either they are shy or do not score yet.
Exactly.
But then they have the paper for it to score here the competition. Please. So, but this in the coffee attribute, this is a little bit different. This has a kind of a dry finish that some people may like, some may dislike. But who like this coffee could give some description for this one?
Somebody?
So, over 85.
Who raised their hand over 85? Give us a description. Come on.
Okay, we need to wake you guys up. We all need to stand up and do some jumping jacks.
Somebody raise their hand who had a score over 85 and tell us why.
Okay.
Okay.
But always I know that one of the more difficult things for the cuppers is one thing is how you find. You find your cup well, you are sure about the score that you wish to give because you are calibrate. Is another way how you can make this in words. It's really difficult. It's a lot of training. I fully understand. So sometimes to give a score, to be in the correct way, is one way. But how you can give all descriptions or full descriptions for these flavors, because it's a thousand of different ways, and it's really difficult. So this is why I always ask, because I have a few words I can take and help for the other cuppers, why you like. So now change the region. This is from Cerrado, is Alto Cafezal, is the farmers. Is Cerrado region, is a pulp de natural new crop. So for this coffee here, over 90, I have some.
Anybody over 90?
No. 85 to 89. One, two.
Large number. Quite a few.
Many, many cuppers here. 80 to 84. Mm-hmm. 75-79. Look, this is almost everyone that score is over 8. Mm. So, I got someone 90 score here, is right?
Yeah. What
from Russia. Alexander, I think.
Alexander.
Yeah.
I liked it very much. It was very balanced, very clean, caramel juicy, a little spicy, and quite clean.
Thank you very much.
Good aroma, very good.
Thank you very
great.
Much. Great. Very good descriptions. Someone more?
Anybody else?
If you could tell about the acidity as well.
Luis.
Luis. However, do as you like.
For me, it was the cleanest and the most balanced and more fruity notes. In the acidity, for me as Colombian, it was not so high.
Yeah.
I will say on the medium, but for me, it was the best in the table.
Wow. Mm. Okay.
Good.
Perfect.
Good. Some other comments?
Let's keep going.
Yeah?
Yeah.
The score about sample number 5 that Edgar is asking, the last sample was around 8 to 8.1, and this sample here is 8.5. And then also one of the, I guess that you have also this kind of fruit here that we call tamarindo taste. Has the same kind of sweetness, but has some like pepper together. Yeah. So interesting.
Sharpness. Mm.
The next one, this sample number 7, Fazenda Recreio, is Mogiana, is another region in Brazil where I have some growers here like Edgar from this region, and also is Grama Valley. This is a pulped natural yellow bourbon, 1,050 meters. For this specific lot, do you have someone that over 90?
Yes.
Yes.
A number.
A few. 85 to 89. Ooh, ooh.
People like this coffee.
Yeah, so far it seems that is the preference. Yeah, the best one. And 80 to 84.
Just a few.
A few.
Okay.
Below 80?
Just one or two.
One yeah. or two. So please, brief comments. So, because this is the best coffee. Tell why you want, share with us, please.
I didn't point at everything out here, but I really, we are talking now that we felt like it was the coffee that changed the most at the same time in the table. Mm-hmm. Felt like it was getting sweeter and then it balanced out and then the finishing was really nice. So,
but again, but a cooler is improving, do you think?
Improving in yeah. curve that kind of improves and get flat. Not really too high increasing, but it's okay. really smooth and crispy and more acidity. And I felt like passion fruit sometimes.
Uh-huh.
So I'm not sure if I get that right there. But yeah, I really like the aroma at the beginning as well.
Great. Others who want to comment on this coffee since it was everybody's favorite?
Yeah, we have some more comments over
okay,
here.
Okay, great.
I found that it was spicy. It was like ginger. It was like ripe melon. And then it had this like bright vibrancy to it. It was the one that was delicate, but also really, really soft on the palate as well, like really creamy.
Well, thank you. Great comments. So this is for us. Also was the coffee that was around 88 points. Some cuppers was 90, some was 88, 89, around this one. Extremely well balanced. And also the acidity was, I mean, just there, refined, there, lively, but not over of the other attributes. So was this example that I like to show you. People, thank you very much. I hope that you can enjoy a lot the entire competition.
And give it up.
Thank you.
Thank you, Silvio.
Big
so
round of
much.
Applause.
Thank you.
Thank you.